CES 2025 has officially started, and the Las Vegas tech event has already had some major announcements from Dell, Nvidia, Samsung, and more. But with over 4,500 exhibitors and 1,100 speakers across 300 plus sessions, it's easy to miss a few things. So here's some of the biggest announcements from CES 2025. The first major announcement comes from Dell, who seem to be taking a note from Apple's branding playbook. At the tech show, they unveiled a total rebrand of their PCs, removing names like XPS and Inspiron and replacing them with simpler ones like Dell, yes, just Dell, which is the everyday laptop for work or school, the Dell Pro for professional productivity, and the Dell Pro Max for maximum performance and demanding tasks. Dell's rationale behind this change is to make it easier to choose a laptop without getting confused by the names. And in defense against the Apple allegations, Dell's executives said that Apple simply doesn't own the word Pro, which is fair, but they've been using it for so long that one could only see the similarities. You can expect the Dell Pros in February and the rest of the lineup later on with updated processors and AI features. Next, Nvidia had some pretty big announcements in both automotive and gaming. Starting on the road, Nvidia revealed that Toyota will use Nvidia's Drive AGX Orin chip and Drive OS to power advanced driver assistance in its next-gen vehicles. And if that wasn't enough, Nvidia's partnership with Continental and Aurora aims to launch autonomous freight trucks by 2027, combining Nvidia's Drive hardware with Aurora's Level 4 self-driving system. On the gaming side, Nvidia finally unveiled its RTX 50 series GPUs. Now this includes the RTX 5090, which will cost you $1,999, not cheap, while the more affordable RTX 5080, 5070 Ti, and 5070 will cost you $99, $749, and $549. Nvidia says that these GPUs are faster than their previous models, include two double flow through fans, and a 3D vapor chamber. All models also include new tech like GDDR7 memory and support for 8K gaming at smooth frame rates. The RTX 5090 will be available on January 30th, while the rest will hit stores in February. But in other news, if no one told you, because I'm definitely the last one to find out, Toyota is building a city. Yes, an actual city. At CES, the company shared a big update on Woven City, its $10 billion project at the base of where else but Mount Fuji. This futuristic city is designed to test new tech such as self-driving cars, robots, and smart homes with real people living there full-time. Toyota's even brainstorming ideas like drones for joggers, racing wheelchairs, and robotic pets for seniors. And you know what? Heck yeah, I'll take two. I'm just joking, Melo. I'm just joking. I'm fine. The first phase is done, and in 2025, Toyota will welcome its first 100 residents, mostly employees, to start shaping what they're calling a living laboratory. Not scary at all. In other news, Samsung's announcements were all about making AI a bigger part of everyday life. Again, not scary at all. In the smart home space, Samsung's SmartThings platform connects to TVs, appliances, and even energy-saving tools like Flex Connect, which helps ease the strain of local power grids. On the entertainment side, their new QLED 8K TVs feature AI-powered picture upgrades, so now even the screen on your fridge can help with groceries or stream your favorite recipe videos thanks to Samsung Vision AI. Outside the home, Samsung is bringing AI to Galaxy devices with smarter health tracking and productivity tools. They're also teaming up with Hyundai to add smart features to electric vehicles, like charging suggestions and using your car's battery to power your home during an outage. Well, that wraps up the biggest announcements from CES 2025. If you want more CES coverage, head over to TechRepublic.com for more. Till next time, this is Emmanuel Jordan with TechRepublic, and thanks for watching.